practice with a buddy. A lot of the things that I was able to accomplish when I was auditioning, and for sure now, a lot of things that I'm able to accomplish while I'm teaching or creating content for you guys is as a result of having a partner or someone to hold me accountable. When I was auditioning for Phantom and for Cavaliers, my roommate and I were both playing, we were going to college together, we lived together, we played in the college marching band together, and we went to all these auditions together. And so what that did is you just had someone that was always working. You know, if the guy next to you is working, you're gonna be less apt to be a bum and sit there and binge watch Netflix. But there's a practical thing that you should also be doing with your buddy. If you've got someone that's going to the audition with you, many of you who are auditioning, maybe you're the top dog at your school. You're used to being the center snare, okay? And being a great center snare versus being a great wingman are two very different skill sets. When you're the center snare, you are listening to the metronome, you're executing your part perfectly so that everyone can just match you. You wanna be the archetype member. You're listening to specific sections. Maybe you're listening forward or you're listening back. You're coordinating between different lines. You have different responsibilities. You're just worried about yourself and then lining up your part to whatever you should be listening to at that moment in the show. When you're a wingman, it doesn't matter what you think is necessarily right or wrong. Your job is to listen or watch, if you're in the front ensemble, and match the person that you're assigned to as your listening responsibility. Just practicing by yourself, which I know many of you are, you're in a room and you're just shedding and working your hands. One of the most important things that you're missing out on practicing, and maybe this is one of, if not the most important thing when you go to an audition, is how well can you play with other players? You could have the best chops in the world, perfect hands, perfect technique, play crazy fast, crazy chops, stick tricks galore. But if you can't play with the people next to you, then it's not gonna work. What the staff is looking for are 8 snares or 9 snares or 10 snares that can play together. They have the same approach. They play well with the people next to them. They need people who can play together. And they need 4 or 5 tenors that can play together. They need 5 basses that gel, right? So as they're moving people in and out of the room or in the spots and out of the spots, they're trying to, you know, create a sound concept of people who are playing together. It's the same thing for the front ensemble, really for any section within an organization. If you've got a buddy, what you should do is take turns being the center snare. So in this rep, or maybe for the next 10 minutes, you're responsible for just being perfect, right? And then this person's job is to listen and match this person. And everyone has a little different, you know, idiosyncrasies. And as the wingman, your job is to be able to anticipate, read, adapt, and follow the person that is your inside listening responsibilities. Because this is what's gonna happen. When you get to the audition, you're not always gonna be standing next to someone that you know or you're familiar with, and how quickly you can adapt to the person next to you. Maybe you need to play a little stronger. Maybe you need to lighten up a little bit. Maybe you need to play a little bit lower, a little bit higher. You have to be able to adjust in the moment. The more of a chameleon that you can be, the less freaked out you'll be when you're in the audition.